Up until 12,000 years ago, humans used to live as hunter-gatherers. They would have to defend themselves from invaders, fight for resources, and pretty much fight for their lives. It was a very unforgiving world. And to be able to survive and reproduce, violent traits were pretty helpful. Someone with these traits was more likely to live long enough to reproduce and pass their genes to the next generation, including the genes that make men more aggressive. For example, now we know that the gene monoamine oxidase, or MAOA, has a variant that makes men more aggressive. The MAOA gene encodes a protein that helps break down serotonin and other neurotransmitters, which are molecules that send signals between cells in the brain and help regulate emotions. So, for someone with a low-functioning MAOA gene variant, there are more neurotransmitters floating around. This disrupts the delicate balance in some circuits in our brain, especially the ones associated with self-control and emotion regulation, which might lead someone to become more impulsive and show difficulties controlling their emotions. Studies have even reported that university students carrying the low-functioning MAOA gene are more prone to be aggressive when provoked. Around 40% of the population carry this low-functioning variant. But even carrying this gene doesn't explain the violent crimes some men commit. I mean, the university students with the low-functioning variant got angry but didn't kill anyone. The other part of the puzzle is the environmental factors. Besides having the MAOA low-functioning gene, the person also needed to have experienced childhood abuse. Just then, the likelihood of someone committing violent crimes increased. You may be wondering, what about women? Surely they also have this low-functioning variant. And they do, but it has a very different effect. Women with a low-functioning variant of MAOA are more likely to be happier than women with the high-functioning gene. An explanation why there is such a stark difference between males and females is not well understood yet. It could be from brain differences and the function of neurotransmitters to the differences in levels of hormones. We just don't know. Other studies also support this combination between genes and external factors playing a role in aggressiveness. And from twin studies, we know that aggressive behavior is 50% genes and 50% environmental factors. So, what are these environmental factors? There is a long list. Common factors include mothers drinking alcohol, smoking, or taking cocaine during pregnancy, a baby receiving inadequate oxygen levels to the brain at birth, and malnutrition during early childhood. There are also socio-environmental factors and dysfunctional environments, including family poverty, parental neglect, homelessness, domestic violence, and living in a community with a high crime rate. All these could influence emotional regulation, especially when talking about children, since their coping capacity to stressful situations is not well developed, and might impact emotional adjustment in their adolescence and even into adulthood. Most men do not become aggressive after encountering stressful events, since they are able to cope with them and become well-adapted adults. Still, adults showing high aggressive behavior are likely to have experienced adversity during their childhood and also have a genetic composition that makes them more likely to show aggressive behavior. If you have anger issues or know someone who has, I hope this gave you more of an understanding of its potential origins. For more information, you can find the sources used in this video in the description below.